Hello friend, welcome to my video. Building your own OpenSSH server can be one of the easiest and most convenient solutions to transfer files over the internet from anywhere. First, set a password for your user account if you don't have it. Next, enable the OpenSSH server in Windows 11. Open the Settings app and go to Apps. On the right, click Optional Features. On the next page, click the button View Features. In the list of features, select OpenSSH Server and click on the Install button. This will install the OpenSSH Server software in Windows 11. At the moment of this writing, it doesn't start automatically. You need to configure it manually. Click the search box and type Services. Then, click the search result with the same name. Find OpenSSH SSH Server and set to Automatic and start them. Next, allow the SSH port in Windows Firewall. By default, the server is using port 22. Opening the SSH port in the Windows Firewall manually. Click on Inbound Rules. In the left pane. In the right pane, click New Rule, select Port, and click on Next. Type the number 22, in the specific local ports option, and click Next. Choose Allow the connection, click Next, and select Private Public Domain for the network option. Give the rule a name. For e.g. SSH. Next, SSH port forwarding on your router. Access the router by browsing the router IP address through web browser. Give a name, for example SSH. Type 22 in both public port box and private port box. Type your computer IP address in private IP box. This is my WAN IP address, this information will be used in the next step. You need to restart your computer to apply all the settings. Let's test if it works. You need an SFTP client to do this. Go to nsoftware.com and download SFTP Drive, it's free software. SFTP Drive is the one I use on Windows, but you may use any other that supports SFTP. Open SFTP Drive and give a name, for example SSH. Give a name, for example SSH. Enter the WAN IP address I got in the previous step. You will need to enter your Windows username and password to allow the program to connect to the server. Now you can transfer files over the internet from anywhere. As always, if you found this post useful, then subscribe to my YouTube channel. Help me 500,000 subscribers.